Hello everybody and welcome back once again. Now, I was having problems with PneumaticCraft, but I wasn't reading things straight, so let's do that again. So what I wanted to do is set up a little pressure chamber here, so let's do that first of all. I don't think I need that. I need some walls, got 22 walls. So what you do, I'll stand on this chest, Pankaton. If we put these down, the angle you put them down at is the way they face, so in this case they're all facing sort of down. I don't think it really matters what direction they are, just so long as they are like that. So of course the corners only need to be walls, and the roof needs to be a roof, so let's just do the roof as well first. I wonder. Yes, that works nicely. And that one. And this one, and therefore this one. So now what we have is the base of the thing. Now what we can do is we're putting some windows. Let's first of all put in the pressure chamber valve, because we need one of those, and that's this boy here, and you press it in the direction you want it to be. So obviously I want it to go that way, and here I built something different. I built some pressure chamber interfaces, but you actually need the pressure chamber to make those. So let's have a look at the recipe for those. First of all, it's fairly straightforward: compressed iron, standard hopper, and these pneumatic cylinders. These were the hard bit, because I had to make some plastic from rain plant seeds there. And this was fairly straightforward, a safety valve with compressed iron. So the plastic, the recipe for that, has just had to put these into the pressure chamber at 1.5 bar, and it just made plastic, and that went very quickly. But let's start with this again. Now these are important, the direction you put them in. So I want this one here to be an output or an export side, and that's where the eye is. The eye tells you it's the input side or the import side, and the same here. So now this is an input. If you look at here, it tells you the status interface. This is a interface mode none, but it is an input, I'm sure of it. So what we then can do, step back a bit, we can take a hopper here, put the hopper above it. I found if I tried to put the hopper on it, I can't reach the actual interface. So what I was going to do is put a hopper there and then a pipe here. So let's just put an item duct. We've got plenty of those. And obviously I always want to have a servo. Yes, we've got a servo. Let's get the servo out of here. Now I can then have an item filter in here. I don't really care about, all I want is really to be enabled. And then we need the crescent timer, and I want to make it an output. So it's coming out of here, and I have to change this, of course, that it's now facing into this duct. So now if we hit click this, we should see still none, probably because we've got no pressure. Oh, it's not yet a, that's why the reason, I think it's not yet a pressure chamber. We have to put in the window or another thing in here. Let's just put the window in here. Now if you heard that, you'd hear some motors going on. So now you see it is a import mode, and around the other side you'll see it's got an O on it, output, and therefore it should say it's in export mode. It is. And here's a filter of items that you can have, or it is actually not the items, this is the types of items. What we want to do is we want to make compressed iron, or we want to make plastic. Let's start with plastic because that's the easiest. Here we've got some of these flowers. Now let's just take my sigil of the green grove again and hit these things. They should, with a bit of luck, maybe let's go and grow up. 1, 2, 3. Wait for that to spit around. And maybe, I think, as it spits a flower. Try again. Try it again, somewhere else. I can hear the mobs in the background. Let's just press, let's put the fire out. There we go, a bit noisy. Try again. Hopefully some will land on the netherrack. I think that's the intention, but they seem to be landing everywhere else at the moment. Not that it'll do obsidian any harm. Really what I want is multiple seeds, so with a bit of that, this is how it works. Sometimes you get some seeds, and I think it spits seeds out. As you can see. Try again. One last time. If it doesn't work, I'll just use the one I've got here. There you go. As you see, it spat out a seed. So I need a little bit of a larger area for that. And these boys are getting a bit noisy, so we'll have to give them a little trimming down, so to speak. In fact, my hopper at the back there is completely full. All sorts of stuff. I probably should dump a lot of it. I'm not going to need it at all. There's only a certain amount of rotting flesh that you can really deal with. And one spider. Which gave me a spider eye. And one last zombie. Oh. Skeleton, another zombie, there's quite a few in there. Right, anyway, so I should have a reasonably full. Yes, nearly 40,000, that's good. So that'll then slowly get used up over time. So let's get back to our pressure chamber here. So with this one seed, what it will make is it'll make plastic. So what we need to do is first of all put it into here. So what we can do is we can say here the input on this is a filter item. It's going to allow that to go in. So now we can put into the hopper this seed. It gets taken out with a bit of luck. If I'm not too slow, you'll see it's actually getting pulled out of here. And it should drop into the pressure chamber. Now the pressure chamber is here. And as you can see, the seed's not in it because it's got no pressure, I think. And when it comes out, we have to do the same thing on the output. So let's give it some pressure for now. So I need my pressure ducts here, my pressure tubes. And I shall put one down here. I have to shift click it. And then up. Try again. And up. So that then joins into here. And then we can put one. Let's put on here the safety valve. Let's put on here the safety valve first of all, and then on this one we need a second, a little bit further away actually. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use another pressure tube, put a pressure tube on here, you'll see why in a minute, and I'm going to put the pressure valve on the top of this like that, and then we need an air compressor. So what I could do, I actually got two, I made a second one. So if I put another tube here and a tube here, like that, and then we can put the two compressors down here. So one can go on there and the other one can go on there. And you see now we have a nice sort of setup. We should be able to click. There's no pressure in there at all, and no recipes, because it hasn't been pulled in yet. So let's give it some power. Now obviously one way to do this is use what I used last time, which was, I've got some stuff I need to get rid of, wood. I don't need to use wood, I can use the lava crystals. So I've got one in here. I'm not going to use this furnace anymore, so I'm going to chop it up, I think, and remove the hoppers. So pick those up. And we shall put it away somewhere. Probably this little chest here will do for the time being, I think. So we've got those two hoppers, and somewhere I've got a... Oh. Did I not pick that up, or did it break completely? Oh, that's interesting. Oh, the furnace is gone. Let's just turn this on, so if we pick it up, because it's gone somewhere strange. Ah, it actually went into the chest because I broke the hopper. Very interesting. Actually, I do need some food. I'm hungry again. So, I've been quite lucky in actually getting multiple lava crystals from bags. Where did I put the other one? Probably in this chest here. I did, yes. So what I can do now, instead of using wood, I can put lava crystals in here. And in here. And if I do use two compressors, it's going to make the rate go faster. And hopefully now, yes, you can hear the motors then just working. And I think what's happened, oh, what have I got here? I've got residue heat railcraft, very interesting. Let's just take the pressure chamber and put in this one here. This is an item, a machine upgrade, life item. What this does is it stops things despawning. So can I get this one out? Residue heat, that's a very interesting item, never seen it before. So I'm going to have to dig away at this. Yes, and that of course breaks everything. Oh, there is my... Let's get this. So there's my plastic. So we put it back again. Oh, we've got to put it back the other way. That's a bit tricky. That was a bit of a silly thing to do. So I have to take this one out of here. And then I can put them in. But they have to go that way. So now that's back again. Now I can put into the pressure chamber the upgrade again. Because every time you do it... See, residue heat, isn't that weird? And I actually got the plastic sheet, which is the one we need for the part of the quest anyway. So we've got to make something interesting. So when you break it, you lose all your thing, your settings, which is, that's okay. It doesn't take too long to fix that. But I think that should be okay. So what do we want to do next? What I can do is, the reason I've got this chest here and my gravity gun, is I wanted to move this gravity chest. I don't know if it'll work, we'll try it. Maybe I wanted to put it there. It just drops down, that's what I thought would happen. Let's drop that there. Let's take something like a piece of dirt or something easy. I don't want to do that there, do I? I probably want to do this. Well, I've got one carpenter's block, that'll do actually. Oh, there is something I can build. I forgot. We can build something else, so let's just put this carpenter block down here. Take this gravity gun here. I don't want you there, come back a bit. I have to walk backwards, do I? Yes, I do. Then let's put it down there. And I can break that. Ooh. That should break that. So now my chest is that way around. It's not the way I want it to be, of course. I'd like to have the opening at the front, so I just hit it with the crescent hammer. Actually, I'll turn that off because that's using LP. Let's have a look. So I've got other things in here, this pressure regulator and some more pieces, which I'm not using at the moment, and some compressed iron. So let's go over here and put away these droppings I've got. So I did build a second chest, and in this chest I've got weapons mostly, and I actually want to show you something to do with that. And in this chest I've just got armor. So the usual trick of joining these two together will give me a almost complete pair of lapis lazuli boots. And the next thing I want to do is get rid of this junk I don't want as well. Oh, look at them, it was full up again. Okay, I don't really want to do this. I mean, it was too much stuff. I want to be able to reach the item hopper with that. Yes. Oh, what happened there? How did that happen there? A little bit of excitement. Gonna have to keep killing these guys until they're all gone. And then go to the chest here and get some more pieces out. If I can reach that chest, I can. A spider, but that's a problem, isn't it? Let's get rid of the spider. Okay. Now let's just take that slab. Oops. Uh-oh. Right, just had a major disaster now. What's going on? So, let's go and fix that. Must have seen me, so let's put down some torches. Let's press F7 to start with. So that they won't spawn while I fix this thing up. Well, there's another space there. And I don't have enough torches. Okay, I have to take the risk and run over and get that quickly. All that stuff there. Ridiculous. And we'll get a chest at the same time. Torches. Ah, yes, I was building one of carpenters as well, wasn't I? So I need some torches, I need some wood. And I don't have enough wood in there. I need some charcoal too, for that matter. Okay, I don't think I can put this in there to make charcoal. Nope. Let's get rid of some of this stuff. I need one torch and then we can be reasonably safe for a while. Okay, one, two, and just a block of wood or two. Got no space for anything at the moment. I wanted these, didn't I? Put that up there. There's a creeper coming along here. Fortunately, this bow's good enough to deal with him. This is why I need the charcoal as quickly as possible. In fact, what I could do is I could take one of these. Oh, look, there's a torch floating around there. Anyway, so. Look at those bats. Where was the space he came from? Probably here. Right. So now things are safe. Let's go and get some chests and get everything put back. I won't spend the whole episode fixing this up. It's not what I wanted to demonstrate at all. Chests, okay, we've got plenty of wood here. Let's do it over here because I've got no space over there. Let's make a couple of chests, actually, four will be fine. And then what I'll do is I'll just drop down here. Hopefully, it hasn't broken too many of my items here. Put that down there and that down there. And then just start shoving stuff into this. Everything, I think I'll put everything in as much as I can anyway. I will keep some arrows, of course that would make sense. Just in case somebody else spawns along. Pick up the next block and do the same thing for them. In fact, let's put Oops. Another explosion just happened, so that's given me a bit of a shock. Where on the earth that was, I do not know. Strange. That's full. That's full. Not red, and it's not night time. Let's put down another chest here and shove this stuff in it. Okay, let's see what else we can pick up. I don't know what's going on. My altar is completely messed up now, of course. It's even disappeared. So I have a bit of work to do. And I don't see any signs of the altar. As it was. That's two ruins of sacrifice. They must have been from the top. Okay. I shall have to leave you for a time being. Oh. That's what happened. That big bang was caused because I was messing around too much and the compressors exploded. Because I hadn't managed to set up the valve yet. Oh dear. Right. What I should have done... here's the safety valve. What I should have done is put down redstone from this. Anyway, I've got no pressure there, so I don't need to worry about that anymore. What a disaster. Okay, I shall stop now and repair everything and be back when I've done that. Until then, bye for now.
Hello again.
Right, I'm back after all that little drama. I've just about finished this. Haven't quite. I thought I'd just saved the last bit. I didn't lose too much. I lost about one or two stones. Get rid of that. That was there so I could place the vacuum hopper, my angel thing. So it's nearly a tier 3. All I've got to now do is put the two glowstone blocks on the corners here. And if I check with my divination sigil, which I have here, if I look at the altar, it should tell me it's a tier 3 altar. It's fantastic. I've lost a hopper from here, of course, which we have to go and make another one of. Let's make another one. But before I do that, one of the things I wanted to do is to make a carpenter, and the carpenter's sturdy casing like this. And the idea of the carpenter is I want to put it here. What I want to do with the carpenter, now I've got seed oil, and here I can take the seed oil and bring it into here, either in buckets or in another way, maybe even with a pipe. And with the seed oil, then I'm going to make an apiary, because I actually have a hive. Look, I shall show you that. I actually managed to... one of those artificial hives actually did turn into a hive. So let's go back. And I think I have some more artificial scented hives. I was redoing those. I think the chance of getting it seems to be about 10%, so it's very, very low. Actually, I preferred, would have put them anywhere, would have put them in one of these two chests. Not there, that was for the item ducts, which I need to make some more now. And I also wanted to show you this. What have I got in here? A chest. My apprentice blood orb. I should take that out. Maybe I don't need that one, actually. Okay. And I wanted to make some leggings. Now, here we have this armor forge again. Now, leggings is just a typical recipe. I think it's 7. So, it's going to be around the outside of it like this. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. So, that's the standard pattern. I right click this, maybe I stick it off it with a bare hand. So now I have some bound, devilish protection bound leggings, which I can replace these for. In fact, no, I need to, first of all, I need to do this with those, don't I? Oops, it keeps going the wrong place. I want it here, because they're not bound to me yet. Now they're bound to me, and they're also on. So the last thing I need to do is to make some boots. But you can't enchant those. So all I need for boots is another 3 filled sockets. So I've got 1 filled socket here, and then I have to make another 3. Let's put that filled socket back over here, because I'm not going to need it for a while now, especially after I've got no blood left. So everything is prepared. Tier 3 altar, I put back these. And I do need to get a hopper, but for the time being, we'll just put the magician's orb in here, I think. And I'll just quickly jump up this ladder and go back into the spawn. And as you can see, I just replaced a few bits of these. It wasn't too bad. I already had extra from the previous time. And that is enough. We get that out of the way and then just fill it in again. So with this bit of luck, they'll start spawning again, and hopefully I've got everything right. I don't know what happened last time. I think he must have just seen me and blew up. I was probably too close. But with the samophone, I can't hear him doing his little hiss. So wait a few seconds, we should get some mobs spawning. Right, next thing to do is to go back and make a compressed chamber. Oh, I have to make a... I did tell you what I lost. I lost those 2 lava crystals. That's a bit of a pain. Before I... because they take a diamond or so to make. But one thing I do want to do is to make a new pickaxe. And for that I need 3. Diamonds, which I have plenty of, so let's just do that first. And the reason I want to make a diamond pickaxe is I'm going to go and put that up here, and I'm going to make it bound. But it's a very dangerous tool, this one. I'm hesitant to actually do this. So I need my weak blood orb here, weak activation crystal, sorry, and I throw that onto here. Let's go up one, throw it on, it's probably easier. Let's get it around about there. Good, and then hit this with the activation crystal and get out of the way. Wait till the fireworks are finished, which I think they have done now. With a bit of luck, I will have one bound pickaxe. Where's it gone to? Oh, we don't have to do that again. Let's put this one on. Oh, it's disappeared. Oh, that's a shame. Anyway, well, let's do it again in that case. Didn't want that to happen, really, did I? Did I only pick up? Yes, I only picked up 2 sticks as well. A lot this time. Mess around. Okay, let's try that again. 3 diamonds, 1 diamond pickaxe, which I shall put here, and I shall return this now, because I don't want this one at the time for the time being. Go up here. I wanted to stand here, didn't I? Okay, fire remote is around about here. Let's throw that down there. Oops, missed. But if I was sensible, I wouldn't do that, would I? Just turn on that sickle off. Right, try again. Hopefully it lands on its place. Hit that, get out of the way. Oops. Where is it? I still don't see the thing. Oh. Well, I'm not going to do that again. It's the same principle as doing a bound blade. It should work. But it seems to, in this case, be taking my diamonds and pickaxe and destroying them. That's nice of it. I wonder why. Is it because I'm in the way? I'll tell you what, let's just have one last go. We don't have an excess of diamonds, so... But I would like a bound pickaxe. This time I'm going to get off the pillar before I hit the, with the activation crystal. Just use this as a place to be. Right. Yes. Uh-oh. Yes, I have my sigil still on. Yeah, I don't want that. Difficult to get into the place when you've got a jetpack. There we go. Try again. No, dropped it. Turn this one on in this case. Turn it off. Try again. Oops. Very clever. Try it again. Right, this time we have success. So let's get out of the way. Let's just hit this now with a... Click it. Ah, there, I've seen it. This time it did actually work, and I don't know what happened to it the previous two times. Now, this is a bound pickaxe, and this thing is seriously dangerous. It's currently deactivated, and I shall demonstrate why it's seriously dangerous in a minute. And it's also not bound to me. The first thing we do is bound it to me. Let's have a look. So now it's owned by me, which is what I need. And it acts like a normal pickaxe for most of the time. But it's deactivated. So let's just build something that I don't want. There's 56 stones. Where shall I go and do this? Somewhere that really doesn't matter. And this path is actually one of those I can easily replace. Here we'll do. Let's just put some stones up here. The pickaxe just acts like a normal pickaxe. I activate it first of all, rushes a right. Is it a shift right? Is it a left click? No, it's a shift right click. Now it's activated. So it just acts like a normal pickaxe bomb. Do that. But now, when it's activated, if I shift a right click it, or is it shift left click? Shift right click it, it will do 11 by 11. Or it should do. No, what am I going to do for this thing? Right click it. There you go. Oops. And that's the danger. It did an 11 by 11 and brought everything to me. But it's really seriously dangerous, that thing. So what we'll do... Fortunately, I have my... I will deactivate this because it does use life essence or LP. Oops, see, I done it again. Let's just go away somewhere safe, like up here, and then shift right click, and then it's deactivated. Phew. So it's a right click, I think, and it does an 11 by 11 block. As you can see, it took out quite a lot of that area. So. Best thing to do is to put it away when it's not in use. Oh look, that's a really weird thing. I wonder if I can put, I don't think I can put a, let's put a block beside this here and then put us, Yes, that's right. Shift it, and then put this torch on. We don't want a mob spawning from there, do we? Right, back to what we're trying to do. I haven't got much time left, but I've wasted quite a bit. I want to also plant a bluebell, because I need to make a glacial precipitator. Because I've got enough seeds now, so what I want to do is to put one seed in here, and we shall say, let's have a look, where is it going to be? So this is here, this is the green corner. I'll do that one. Let's do it on the blue corner. Yes, let's do it on this blue corner here. So the cyan corner. So what I want to do is put one seed in there. Take this out. So what it's going to do is hopefully plant that one seed in there. The rest of it can, of course, be normal seeds. So what happens then is that something has to grow up, and then it should simply plant one down here when it's ready. I hope. Nope, it didn't. Planted a normal crop. Tell you what we'll do. I have got that the right way around, haven't I? Let's take the one seed out of here and put that, and actually plant that one seed while we can. And that should multiply. We'll see. Anyway, for another time. Because that will give me snowballs. Oh yes, that was what I wanted to do. I turned off my jetpack actually because I need to fly everywhere. I needed to make a new compressor, didn't I? Let's do that first. So one furnace. No, that gravel, that's cobble, good. Oops, I just made blocks, haven't I? Try that. Pull this back again. Right, to furnace. And then we need some pipes and some compressed iron. Compressed iron I've got plenty of. We'll make two of these, I think. And then we just need two pipes, which I think are in this chest over here. Nope, not that one. It's the one at the back, of course. Two. And this time we will not mess up. But I haven't got any more source of power, so I'm going to have to make a lava crystal. In fact, they are possible to make. So let's put these. What do we lose? A pipe? Yes, we lost one pipe as well, didn't we? Well, I did anyway. I place these two beside each other. I think it was just here like that. Ooh, weird. And then I put the two air compressors down here and here. Then we just need some fuel. So what we were, I was trying to show was something else, wasn't it? So what I was going to do, yes, let's do it like this. This pressure gauge here actually emits a redstone signal by the amount of pressure that's actually in it. And this one here, which is the safety valve is here, this one, we can use it in the opposite way. So this is basically, at the stop of that is 7.5 bar. And for each pair of these is one bar down. So we need, say, five. Five is 2.5 bar, so that'll give me five. Let's say, if I put a redstone torch here, I should be getting a redstone signal of around about, I'm not, power 10. 15. Now, good, I can see it. So that should then limit this to, I think that limits it to too little. Let's just take that out of the way. But not put it down here. Maybe that was why I was only ever reaching just under 2 bar. Now the power is 8. So if you look at this thing here, it should tell you. Maybe I have to have that in my hand. Okay, let's do that. Yes, here we are. So the redstone times a half. So that's going to give me 2.5 bar at this distance, which is enough to make compressed iron. So let's put that back again now. Very complicated. So now I've got to make some lava crystals. Let's have a look, because I haven't made any of those so far. I know that I think it's just a diamond or so. Three buckets of lava, one diamond, one weak blood orb, and two obsidian, two glass. Not too difficult. I'm running out of diamonds fairly quickly though. But I'm not running out of obsidian anymore. And I'm not running out of buckets of lava either. I've got some buckets, we need 6. And then we need our lava sigil. This one here, which will just fill up some buckets. I think I can do this. I don't think I can do it from here. If I can, that'd be good. Oh, I can. Right, good. Smashing. So we needed a weak blood orb in the middle and 3 buckets of lava, like this, I think, and then 2 pieces of glass. We get 1 crystal and the next 3 buckets of lava. That is not a bad reward to get anyway. I guess we've got plenty of mobs spawned again. Good. So let's go first of all bind those to my network. That should be now bound. This one needs to be bound too. So they will then use power from the network. That's how it works. And let's put these two into here. And this time it should not explode. But it was a big explosion. I'm glad I wasn't too near. Right, here we go again. This distance I'm perfectly safe. The only way I go and have a look in the inside to see whether it's a problem or not is when things start to go wrong. And I've done it a lot, so they don't go wrong too often, fortunately. That was the first time it went wrong. And what I haven't done is I haven't configured the vacuum hopper. Let's do that as well. All this. Where's my food? Can't hear myself eating because of the muffler. The muffler does work in mysterious ways, that's for certain. There is a spider in there actually. Have I got any? Yes, there's a spider. Right, that's probably the dangerous bit there. Let's go around the side here. This is also a weeny bit dangerous. And configure this thing because I haven't done it. So, items. We need to say, and I think it's the far side, isn't it? No, it's not. It's, I think it's this end here. And this side, I think, is where it should go. Oh, we haven't joined the item ducts together, that doesn't help, and this is also a dangerous place. Let me just see if this is working. Yes, that's working fine. Good, I can put all the way. Lots of seeds. Don't need zombie brains. Don't need too many arrows. Don't need rotting of flesh. How am I doing now? Looking a bit better. Don't need those. We will take away these though. And that's the servo, which I should have. Where did that get from? Ah. That's interesting. I was actually sure I had done that. So I've got to be careful here because I don't want to be seen. So let's put the server, let's put the fluid duct on here. And that should join up to that item duct here. Let's change the configuration of the item duct here. Oops, wrong button of course. Put this on here. I think that's the right place. Right click that. Take the crescent hammer and right click that, so it's then an output, and then it should go into here. Good. But in fact the tank's full, I should move the tank. Let's do that as well, because I've got a spare tank here as well. Take that tank. Oops, that tank went straight into the vacuum hopper, so did that one. And there's the empty tank. Let's just put the empty tank. That was funny, wasn't it? To put it down there, and then it gets filled up with the almost straight away, which is great. And take that out. Don't need that in there, do I? What else have I got in there? Anything interesting? Just the head. Okay. And the other stuff, by the way, is still underneath. I haven't picked it up for when it's putting those chests down. This is where I put the heads, and this is where I put the armor. And what I did want to do. Look at those steel leggings. Oh, those are the ones I had before. I was to show you something else. How to make your enchantments better. So here I've got a bow. Let's take a full one. Here I've got a power one bow, and here I've got another power one bow. Here I've got a power two bow. And I've got a second power two bow. Right, now if I take this one, for example, here, which is power one. Yes, I'll do that like that. You'll see that you get a full bow, but it's not powered. It's not a, it's got no enchantment. So if we go now and take that to the anvil, if I do it on that one, it just does it too fast. You can't see what's going on. But if I take this power one bow and this normal bow, it costs me 6 to give me a power one, and I get a power one this time full. If I take the power one here and another power one, it costs me 8 and I get a power two bow. If I do the same thing with the two power two bows, you get a power three, and the cost goes up all the time. And that is how you get better bows. That's how I got a power five bow. I just kept doing that. And it's quite effective. It kills certainly spiders and zombies in one hit. In fact, let's just prove it. If I can reach this guy, which is going to be hard. Maybe I got him, I don't know. He's jumping up and down anyway. That one does would go through. So just up there is enough drop. No. Do it this way. At least I get blood in the altar doing it that way. And this one here is a spider, and the one hit with a spider will kill a spider. And now there should be nothing in the hoppers, that's good. Okay. What I can also do, that's just a sideline here. I don't know what it affects it, probably does. So I put that, if I put this tank down here, made it an output tank, it would fill up that, but I think it reduces the effectiveness of the enchantment table. So we won't do that for the time, but we can just put it down here somewhere. It can stay there till I need it. Right, let's have a look. So now we have 3.5 bar. So these are working quite nicely. Now, what you can also do with these, by the way, is to, let's take some ordinary iron, which should be in this chest here, 64. Let's just take half of that. And I want to put these into this thing without losing pressure. What I do, of course, is I right-click on this, on the chamber, set this as a filter, so I want iron items to go in. And I also want to get, if possible, which of course you always have the first time, compressed iron coming out. Right, that's a steel ingot, compressed iron. So we've got our compressed iron. Now I want that to come out here. So I can just reach this here so I can get the interface. And I say I want a compressed item to come out. So now I come along here and put my items, my 32 iron ingots, and they disappear fairly quickly. Of course they're in here now, they get dropped out because they're in the input interface. We should be able to see them in the window, and when they're processed or compressed, they will end up in this chest here. So then we've got three, but let's just take those out so we can see that we're actually getting three. 25, how about that? And it is 100% efficient. So these others will also get compressed. And obviously it's doing it in batches. So we can wait a few seconds. There we go. And they're also being drawn out of the interface here in the same way as the other one was, if I'm not mistaken. Five have come in, drops them out into the chest, and voila. And it's open again. So here you've got your 31. I must have taken one out already. Or is there one in here still? No, I can't see any. Now another thing we can do is, we don't want to waste all of our energy. We can take some levers here, put them beside the air compressors. That's why I misread that. I said no problems. But you can do a redstone signal, so you can say on a high signal, generate only on a high signal. So at the moment that is presumably off, so that should therefore be off. .7 bar. Information, so look, that doesn't help me very much. And that's upgrade information. Oh yes, it has gone off, fantastic. And we do the same on this side. We'll set the redstone signal to be on high and turn it off. That's an off signal. And that's now going to disappear. Just to prove it, let's turn it on here. You see, it comes up straight away. And this is self-contained, I don't need to do any more than that now. But if the pressure goes too high, the valve now releases it instead of it going bang. And here you can see this gauge. And this gauge is also telling me it's just under 3 bar. And that should tell me, zero power, here's 1. So if you count those, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that must be the 3 bar. That's when that works out. Maybe it's 2.5. If it's underneath 3 bar, let's double check that, because you can see it here exactly what you're getting. 2.9, so that's 2.5, that makes sense. Okay, that was an interesting day. Until next time, bye for now.